So today I will be sharing how to empower your mindset in less than 10 minutes in a 6-minute video. And there's two parts to reframing this into a more empowering mindset. Welcome back to Mindfulness Monday, here to give you an empowering start for your week in a swift, impactful, and enjoyable way. All right, let's get this framing started and remember to smash that like button. Part one, and how you're dealing with the thing or the situation. How are you looking at it? And when I ask that question, it's which lens are you looking at this through? Are you looking at this with disempowerment or empowerment? So let me go ahead and kind of like unpack that a bit more. Realize when you're looking at things with the disempowerment lens, it's typically blame and victim. He did this to me, she did this to me, they did this to me. And realize when we come from that perspective, nothing will change. Also, the focus is assigning fault or responsibility to someone or something else. And this can cause a sense of helplessness or disencouragement. And it shifts the focus away from personal growth and problem solving. And always to remember where focus goes, energy flows. So let's go ahead and attempt to look at this through the more empowering lens versus the disempowering lens. And now the second part, question asking time. While you're viewing this through your empowerment lens, when you attempt to answer these questions, answer it in the positive. Okay, question one, how can I learn from this? Question two, what can I learn from this? And this third question is going to most likely be a bit of a challenge, especially if you happen to be looking at the situation as a perceived loss. What have I gained from this experience? And here, I'll give you a real life example from my own life in a situation. When I was losing my ability to walk because I was in such an unbearable pain constantly, and in addition, doctors telling me there's nothing I could do about it, I have to just learn to manage it and tolerate it. So instead of going into that victim and blame mode, I had shifted it to look at it through a more empowering lens. So I started to look for ways how to deal with the pain naturally and how to help myself in this situation. From there, I learned about grounding, turmeric, and from that searching, I ended up finding a clinical trial, being the second person administered in that group. And to this day now, I am no longer in the wheelchair and no longer in that unbearable, constant pain. Now, if I would have stayed in that blame victim state and looking at things through the disempowerment lens or disempowering lens, I most likely never would have found those answers. So now you see the power of going and viewing things through a more empowering lens versus a disempowering lens, and being able to empower yourself. And in case you're wondering, no, I wasn't raised with this kind of a mindset. This mindset was acquired later in life. I'll put it this way. By the time I was 16, I'd already experienced 3 divorces, 3 infidelities, 2 abandonments, and some abuse. And I share that to show, despite of having a challenging childhood, there's still a chance to shift to a more growth mindset, to a more empowering mindset. All right, quick recap. So view from the lens of empowerment with this situation. Part two of the process is now to ask yourself those questions. What have I learned from this? How can I learn from this? What have I gained from this experience? And I realize that last one might be a bit of a challenge because, wait a minute, I've lost a loved one. And yet remember too, you just gained some wonderful memories and also to gain that experience of having that kind of love. Alrighty, well, I appreciate your time today. Keep empowering that mindset and continue having an amazing rest of your day. I'll see you next Monday. Bye for now.